Hey guys, so today I'm going to show you guys how I make my vegetable glycerin mix. For those who don't know what vegetable glycerin is, it's basically a moisturizer. It makes your hair very, very soft. People usually use it in, if they make homemade soaps or homemade lotion, they'll use glycerin. Glycerin's found in lotions and soaps and everything. It's just a good thing. It makes your hair soft, it makes your skin soft. It's somewhat of a humectant, meaning that it kind of takes in moisture and puts moisture back into your skin or your hair or wherever you're putting it. A lot of naturals use vegetable glycerin mixes to just soften their hair, just like a daily spritz, or use it as kind of a oil sheen type thing. That's how I use it. Like, I kind of use it the same way I used to use my oil sheen back in my relaxed days. So, I will show you all what I do. I take just the old conditioner bottle. This is a Perfective toothpaste leave-in conditioner bottle. And I like this bottle because of the way it sprays. It's not like a big glunk of spray. It's mist around my hair. And I like that much better. And I use this bottle because the conditioner that came in, it was actually very similar to how my vegetable glycerin is. That's to say that it had like a oil base and then like a water base. And that's kind of how vegetable glycerin mix goes. And you had to shake it. That's what I have to do with my vegetable glycerin mix. I have to shake it and then spray it. So, that's why I use this bottle. But you can use any spray bottle. You can find spray bottles at Sally's or any hair salon, any hair store. Or you can use the type of spray bottles that I would use for like my water if you want to like really pack on the vegetable glycerin. But for me, my hair is thick, but like it still absorbs moisture pretty okay, so I don't need like toweling anymore. So I don't really need big spray bottles where it's spraying a lot at one time. So this works for me, fine what works for you. I'm like rambling a lot right now, sorry. But anyway, so I take my bottle. Now I take my vegetable glycerin. I got this from the health food store. You can get it online. I know Big Lots sells, I don't know if they sell vegetable glycerin, but they sell glycerin. And I don't know what the big difference is, but I mean, I don't know. Some people just use regular glycerin for their glycerin. I like vegetable glycerin. I've never used glycerin, so I don't really have anything to compare it to, but get whatever one you desire. But what I do is I use the bottle to like measure things, and I fill the glycerin up to the top of the barcode. So and I'd say this is about 2 tablespoons, a little more. So, see, that's how much vegetable glycerin I use. About 2 tablespoons. And then I take my oil, and you want to, the only reason I'm using oil is because I use essential oils. I use rosemary and peppermint. If you're going to use essential oils, you need to have a oil as a base so that it doesn't like overpower the formula, because essential oils are very powerful, and too much of them can mess your hair up or jack your scalp up. It won't be a good thing to use too much essential oil on your hair. So you want to have an oil as a base, and I use jojoba oil only because it's the closest to the oil in my scalp. So I figure if I'm spraying this on my hair, I'm getting, you know, my scalp oils all the way to my end. So I almost forgot how to do it. This stuff lasts me for over a month, like a month and a half, this one bottle. So sometimes I forget what I do. But what I do is I take 2 capfuls of jojoba oil. I'd say 2 capfuls is about a tablespoon. Yeah. usually do this over a sink, so you can make it. Alright, so I got 2 tablespoons of jojoba oil. Alright, so you see how much jojoba oil is there. About that much. And then I take my essential oils, and I have my peppermint, and I do 5 drops of peppermint. And the reason I like peppermint is one for its smell, because I use the rosemary for hair growth, and rosemary stinks. So one for the smell, and one because it's good for scalp and things like that, so it helps. Also, it helps in the aid of hair growth. 5 drops of peppermint. And then 10 drops of rosemary. And rosemary is a good essential oil if you want your hair to grow, which is what I want my hair to do. I use rosemary. So I take 10 drops of rosemary. And then I top it off with water. And I use distilled water, regular distilled water. You can use sink water. Sometimes I use drinking water if I have some drinking water left. But I don't right now. And I just fill it up with water. I don't fill it all the way to the top. I fill it like. And that is my vegetable glycerin. What I do is I just dig it up and spray it. And I've said in other videos, I spray this up in my hair every day. Usually at night, after I set my hair, I'll spray with this. Or if I don't spray it at night, in the morning, once I'm done styling my hair, however I'm going to do it, I'll top it off with some vegetable glycerin. So again, if you feel like your hair isn't as soft as you want it to be, I would really recommend buying some vegetable glycerin, getting some oils, some water, some essential oils maybe, and spraying some vegetable glycerin. Some people make it real simple. They just really like half vegetable glycerin, half water. I don't need that much vegetable glycerin in my hair, so it's not that deep for me. But if your hair is like really hard and you just really want to get it soft, I would suggest some vegetable glycerin for you. And if you use the method I use, then let me know how it goes. And that's all I have for you today. I'm sitting precious tonight, so I'm very excited. My mom saw it last week. She didn't really like it. She said she was expecting it to be like the color purple. And I'm not really sure why she expected that, but that's what she expected, and it wasn't like the color purple. So I don't know. I think her expectations are too high. So I'm trying not to like get too geek. So I'm just gonna go in with a clean, clear head and just watch Precious, and I'll probably be crying a bucket load. But you know, hey, I think that the movie is supposed to bring tears, so it's okay. So I will see you guys in the next video, which might actually, it might be a while until my next video because finals are coming up. Like last time, I had to take like a month and a half hiatus. I'm probably gonna take another month and a half hiatus again because, yeah. I did much better last semester than the semester before. So every semester I'm getting better grade-wise. So again, I hope to keep that up. So it's crunch time. I have about 3.5 weeks until my first exam. Very, very nervous about that. So yeah, it might be about a month or so until I make another video. But I'm going home next week, so if I have any free time next week and I have something to do a video on, I'll make a video just because, I mean, it's not like I'm having to be in class or anything next week. So I should have a little free time, but you never know. Law school crap. Deep. But anyway, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.